Citytv, Channel 79, Cable 7.
America's full of songs for cities, and we have this one.
Find yourself in people's city. Stay a while if you can, with folks who will be tomorrow's faces.
Moses, when he said, "I want a love song," that was it.
It spoke to the time, and it spoke to a time still evolving.
It should be the song for Toronto.
Toronto.
I don't know what happened.
That's People City.
People City, pretty good idea if you lived up to
makes
it.
Makes old dreams happen.
Molson Canadian, brewed by men who know their beer. Drink Molson Canadian, lager beer.
I had heard maybe a little teeny whip about people singing commercials in studios. Meant very little to me, zero really. I mean, I knew how to sing, I knew that. Give me a song and I'll do it, man. I got a call from Richard Morris, Dolores Claim, and they were in the jingle business. And they got all the major clients, the GMs, the SOs, all the rest of them. She phoned, and I got this phone call. She said, "Have you ever sung a commercial?" I said, "No, where do I show up?" I went down, I sang it, and of course, my musical talent went with me, and I sang it as a song, and she was knocked out with that.
Hello, morning. It's a new tang morning. It's a fresher way to begin your day.
A good jingle writer writes like that. He writes a song. He doesn't just write a jingle. So it was good for them. It was good for me. And all of a sudden, bingo, it just took off.
Morning sunshine. Morning is on you. Morning is Maxwell House time. Maxwell House and you.
Fool. Full-bodied aroma, full-bodied taste.
I would not be here without Tommy Ambrose. And Tommy and I met through the advertising business, and it was just a natural fit.
I mean, Gary's a brilliant writer. Idea-wise, concept-wise, and then song lyric-wise, he kept bringing me slogans. And I just had a knack as a tunesmith.
So spread your sunshine all over the place.
Kool-Aid. Oh, the Kool-Aid was great, yeah. And then, of course, you got to wear a mustache for milk.
Wear funky old hats.
The grandfather's fats. Wear a mustache.
What a hit. I mean, that's a hit line.
Wear a mustache.
Knapsack bags.
A vest made of flags, but wear a mustache.
And then get cracking.
Get cracking.
Same idea. When you eat your Smarties, do you eat the red ones last? Well, he wrote that line, but I put it to music.
When you eat your frogs, do you eat the red ones rock? Do you suck them very slowly or punch them very fast?
And the ad business was exciting in Toronto. You know, if you want to get a hook on what's going on in a city, financially or show business or music, whatever it is, check the ad world. The advertising world will tell you a lot. And Moses, I knew, would be checking into that because we had a lot of hit commercials. And a lot of them were recorded at Thunder Sound.
Citytv was hatched out of the offices of Thunder Sound. Thunder Sound was a rescue operation because at the time I had left the CBC and begun my apprenticeship in business on Bay Street in the office of Ben Webster, who was one of the first venture capitalists in Canada. The way I learned what little I learned about business and numbers, none of which I had ever dealt with before, was by shutting down or trying to fix some of the investments that he had made that weren't going well. But there was a member of his family who had fallen in love with music and the life of music and the sex, drugs, and the rock and roll, and had ended up funding the development of a recording studio, which was on the lip of being open, but had vastly overrun its budgets and was in trouble. Thunder Sound had what at the time was the first 24-track soundboard in the country. And that was its major selling point. It was able to rescue the studio in part by securing the services of a known hit jingles technician at the soundboard called Phil.
Thunder was a hot studio. It was really good. Phil Sheridan, of course, made it a hot studio because he was a brilliant engineer, sound engineer. God bless him. He's gone too soon.
I got Phil to come to work at Thunder. And with Phil came the jingle business. And the jingle business was the mainstay of the music and the studio business at the time. Independent Canadian Records just getting going. There was Anne Murray on the horizon.
Hey, what about me?
But it wasn't yet a full-fledged big deal, and the studio depended on the jingle business, and the king of the jingle business was Tommy Ambrose.
You want him happy and really alive, to dig into his food and be satisfied.
Beef, chicken, liver flavors. A complete meal. A satisfying meal.
All right, time.
These guys made music to order. And that you could have a kind of interpretive, emotional, touchy-feely sort of conversation about a mood that you might want to evoke. And they'd come back a couple days later and give you some pretty good approximations in very short bursts. Television had a beginning and an end every day at that time.
This is the Global Television Network, concluding its program service for today.
I didn't want to open the day and close the day with either an anthem. Or the Queen, those were what things were doing. I wanted an alternative. I wanted for the city, not for the nation. So I approached Tommy and I said, I need a sign off, but I want a love song.
To really, really do the job, you've got to have that kind of a direction. And Moses, when he said, I want a love song, that was it.
What do? I write commercials. I wrote catchy commercials that are all, a lot of them hits. So he said, I want something like that for Citytv.
I was at home, Tommy phoned and said, can I come over? He came over and he said, gee, I got this opportunity. We're gonna do a song about Toronto. I'm not kidding you. I said, I already know the title. And he said, what's that? I said, it's People City. That's what the city is all about, people. It's People City.
A love song is about life.
Love songs have to be simple. And they have to be meaningful.
I want a story about life. What are we all doing here? We're living life.
I wanted the People City to be real.
It doesn't always have to be sappy and syrupy, but it should be about life, reality. What goes on in your life? Van Gogh said this, no matter what your talent is, you'll never be an artist unless you can love people.
I got people to understand that it was a living document. It wasn't some kind of frozen thing the way everybody else's O Canada and God Save the Queen were, and that it should reflect, and over time, try and catch the whole sweep of the city and the city as it was evolving and growing.
That's what People City had about it. It was open and simple for everyone. Didn't matter if English was your first language or not. And that was also the great community aspect that Citytv gave Toronto.
CITY, Channel 79, Cable 7, Toronto.
They understood that television was about motion and not simply talking heads and still bodies. You knew you were part of the new action. If you were on Citytv, it maybe not have had the largest audience, although its audience was growing like crazy, doing really well with the blue movies and particularly. But it was growing. But what you knew you were doing is that you were into the future. You were a part of the action that was going to bring the future, not something that was going to pay homage to the past.
Horace Campbell is also with us, and you are a Rastafarian.
Yield right? A Rastafari, I am one.
In City, you know, I was building quite deliberately a language of minus signs, as it were. I had seen and studied what conventional television did, and I didn't want to do any of those things. So You could describe City as not this, not that, not that, not that, not that.
Boogie!
We had to, in many cases, break all the standard rules of television just to get ourselves a niche in the marketplace.
You knew that you were in an innovative place, and therefore, your own thinking had to keep pace with that.
Well, I was walking down the street one day, and I saw Moses Znaimer, and he said, "What are you doing tonight?" And I said, "Nothing." He said, "Good. We have very tough qualifications for our new television station. What you have to be able to do is walk in, sit down, and talk." And I said, "I can do that." He said, "You're hired."
Moses immediately began to be hiring people from all walks of life. In short, the people who worked there and worked with him were reflecting, didn't forget the old folks, the old crowd, but they were reflecting a new Toronto, a sense of what Tommy Ambrose later called People City. Moses was hiring those people.
Toronto.
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 Citytv, Channel 79, Cable 7.
People were striving to celebrate the new diversity. One thing that was very big, starting in the late 60s, was Metro Caravan. It was 10 days a year. It was an attempt to try and bring people together, people from all around the world, and they did it, of course, by exposing all of us to the cuisine, history, official dances, traditional garb, all of that stuff in these various pavilions. And at one time, they had 52 pavilions. I was asked not too long ago, whatever happened to Caravan? What really happened is that Toronto became Caravan. Now you don't have to wait 10 days a year to go and have international cuisine of some kind or listen to ethnic music. You just have to get on the subway. The Toronto that Moses was projecting in all of his kinds of programmings, in many ways we became what he was projecting. Yes, he reflected the new city, but he was shaping its instincts as well.
That each show is a daily installment in the real-life saga of what it means to be living in a wonderful town on the north shore of Lake Ontario, at the center of Canada, and determined to be great.
It was housed at Citytv, but it was far beyond that. And people understood that. It spoke to the time, and it spoke to a time still evolving.
And you heard the song a lot, because City was watched a lot, and it was all over the place. And places like CFRB played that song. Wally Crowder played that record, because it was on a 45. He played it because he loved the song.
That was presented to the city of Toronto, all the councillors and council, as a theme song for the city.
It should be the song for Toronto. It should be like a San Francisco, only about Toronto. And it never quite, it always got blocked politically. I don't know what happened. They said, no, we can't get behind that because, you know, we're Mississauga, we're not Toronto. We're Scarborough, we're not Toronto.
And I remember a bit of the debate for people in Etobicoke, perhaps North York and Scarborough. They wanted more of the metro and less of the city.
He was disappointed because he took it to the council meeting and said, you know, here's the song about the city. And for all these petty little reasons, it didn't happen.
People's City was not about boundaries and borders. They missed the notion that wherever you are in the world, you don't say, I'm from southern Scarborough. Or you don't even say, I'm from Cabbage Town. Or you don't say, I'm from Parkdale. You say, I'm from Toronto. Because Toronto's an idea. It's a place and an idea. That's what Citytv was about. And that's basically what People's City was about.
As the city grew, the tempo of the city began to get more urgent and strident. And the song began to feel, a little dated. But what really pushed the song aside was not so much a matter of taste, but when we went 24 hours, we had no beginning and we had no end.
Get set, Toronto. City's going 24 hours.
Tell me about it.
Tempo picks up and the funkiness begins to show. Use of it fell off, and I began to try and direct the use towards programs as opposed to the station.
Toronto is People City. People on the go in a city on the grow.
And Citytv is People City's People Station.
I did a TV show called Tommy Ambrose and Friends, and I closed the show to Find Yourself in People City.
Find yourself in People City. Hey, stay a while if you can. With folks who will be tomorrow's faces, kicking those traces, showing you places. Right here in T.O. Bye and God bless you.
Yeah, it was kind of sad. It's kind of sad to say, you know, at least if it was recorded by not only me, but other people, you know, and some, you know, they play it just the way they play Chicago, the way they play San Francisco, the way they play New York, New York. I mean, wow. I mean, why not? This is a pretty exciting city.
The song itself was not a jump-up tune. It was more of a hymn. It was more of a hymn to the place in a secular sense. And for Tommy, he was born out of the evangelical movement musically years before. So maybe he meant it to be a kind of hymn, but certainly I saw it that way, and others did as well.
Here's Tommy Ambrose.
Shout the sound, spread the blessed tidings all the world around. Tell the joyful news wherever man is found. Whosoever will may come. Whosoever will, whosoever will, send the proclamation over vale and hill. Tis the loving Father calls the wanderer home. Whosoever will may come. Oh yeah!
Tommy is able to get inside the lyric. It's not done by many people. Dean Martin was a great lounge singer. One or two takes, that was it. Incredible. You always got Dean Martin. He was terrific, but no soul. If you said to him, can you give me a little bit more tear or a little bit more robust? No, you bought Dean Martin. And Tommy is not like that. Tommy can go anywhere.
My mother was very interested in the Baptist-type evangelical church. My mother thought that this was the greatest thing since sliced bread, that she had this little kid that could sing. And she taught me all these gospel songs. I don't know where she got them. And at that time, Charles Templeton was big in that area. He was interdenominational. He was trying to include everybody. And he had a great young following at the Avenue Road Church. He had 2,500 people there every Sunday night. And he got wind of it. And when he saw this, of course, whew, lights in his eyes, because he liked the show business side of doing the gospel work. He was way ahead of his time. And he kind of exploited me in a little bit. He gave me the name Tiny Tommy Ambrose. Ridiculous, but I mean, what did I know at 5, 6, 7 years old? That's how it started. I kind of got better because I had a natural voice that could sing. A great piano player was Ted Smith, who went on to be Billy Graham's organist and piano player. It was a hoot for me. I mean, you can ask me what I remember. Just little snippets of things, you know, sitting on the platform, waggling my legs, trying not to chew gum. My mother there telling me, don't do this, don't do that. There's hundreds of people watching you. And that's how it started for me.
When the internet came and YouTube came, I mean, the number of people that have kept that music and put visuals to it is quite fantastic.
There are melodies and themes that last forever.
It's satisfying that it's still alive because it's a good thing. It was a good thing. It deserves to be remembered.
So People City captured its time, but it captured its time in a way that it was capturing the bit of the past, certainly the present, and spoke to the future, which is why it still continues.
The fact that People City was accepted by the people, that feels pretty damn good.
The city wants a slogan as simple as that. People City, pretty good idea if you lived up to it.
It so reflected the tremendous ingathering of people and the sense of opportunity for creativity that people had from all walks of life, from all parts of the world. that People's City just fit so well. So it began and ended. It began when I was born, it'll end when I die.
We got to talk about it and sing about it. People's City. My kind of town.
Find yourself in People's City.
I'm Moses Znaimer, and yes, I commissioned People's City.
Stay a while if you can.
I'm Gary Gray, and I wrote the lyric for People's City.
Who will be tomorrow's faces? Kicking the traces.
I'm Tommy Ambrose, and I sang People's City.
In Toronto, that's People's City.
I'm David Crombie, and I was lucky enough to be the mayor of People's City.
Where love takes hold, makes old dreams happen. She makes you feel things, so buried feelings take on old meaning. In Toronto, that's People's City.
We two are eight, I have almost lost. And roll it in nine, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two.
Mr. Crawford blamed it all on Mommy Dearest, but there's a lot of evidence.
1 minute, folks. Standing by.
Welcome to the 20-minute workout.
Sorry. Coming to you on Toronto Rocks.
Well, we talked about this upstairs, so
winter's white, in People's City. Green ravine makes summer pretty. When leaves start to turn, then the rainbow burns. That's when you learn that you're in Toronto. That's People's City. Yes, People's City. We're in Toronto. So nice to be here. Yes, it's nice to live it. Very, very, very nice.
Find yourself in People's City. Stay wild if you can. Hi, folks. Welcome to Showtime in Oakville.